Hi, Jason Brewers. Today I played a league game and I just want to analyze the game here and share it with you. I played against a guy, you know, traded 1,780, so 30 rating points above me. Before the game I thought I was going to play white, but some last minute changes in the roster, it meant that I was moved to another board, and so suddenly I was going to play black. So that was a little bit of a surprise, but yeah, you never know who you're going to play in these matches anyway. So I hadn't prepped anything. My opponent started with d4, I played d5, then c4, c6, the Slav defense, and e3, and now knight f6, and here my opponent played knight to c3, I made a pawn pyramid, and I think I have a very solid position here, and my opponent continued with knight f3. And here I had a choice between either playing a bishop to d6 or knight to d7. I could also play a6, or actually also bishop to e7. But the two moves I considered was knight to d7 or bishop to d6, the reason I considered it was this move c5 that could stop my bishop coming to d6. I decided that it wasn't really something I should worry about, and I like the idea of getting my knight out and being able to take this e5 square. So I played knight to d7, and my opponent went for the variation with the c5, which is something I'm not seeing very often when I'm playing online, and I think it's one of the few times I've tried to play against it. So I was already in new territory here. I continued with the e7, but there are some games in the database with the b6 here, and then white continued with the b4 protecting this pawn, and now black can play a5, which is breaking down this structure. White continues with the b5, then bishop to b7 and bishop to b4, and I think black here has a nice position, but I couldn't really I didn't know this theory, and but I do now, so I'm better prepared for next game. But b6, b4, a5, b5, and bishop to b7, then something that's good for black. But I played bishop to e7. My opponent continued with his plan, b4, very aggressive play, and I have thought, okay, if he's going to attack on the queen side, I need to get ready to push this pawn and do this that before castling, because I need to get some counterplay in the center. So I played the queen c7 in order to reinforce this push, my opponent played c2, queen c2, and now I pushed the a5 pawn. And you can see here if he takes, then I can just take with the knight, and I think that's very pleasant. And now this push here is not so strong anymore. So my opponent played bishop to b2, and here I thought about taking here first, but after the simple recapture, then I didn't really see anything that's particularly good for me, and I don't have any attack here in the center, and now my opponent can continue on the queen side and castle king side. So I thought I had to go e4, and this knight is now forced back, because I don't think if it goes here I can play h6 and then can go back here, and I don't think that's particularly good for white. But you never know. But my opponent also played knight to d2, which was the move I had looked at, and I castled, and now he played f3, trying to break up my center, but I think it helped me. I took, and now I have there's a weak pawn on e3, and my pieces can come into the attack, and I think it's good for me. But I think for that reason he did not take with the knight, but he took with the g pawn, and now he wanted to attack my king instead and castle king side. So definitely an aggressive opening for white, and I was a little bit pressured, you might say, but I thought, okay, if I'm playing a sound developing moves, it should be okay, and I can maybe attack his king later. So I played b6, trying to break up this queen side. Now that I'm knowing he wants to castle queen side, and he played bishop to d3. I took. Here I should maybe have looked at this idea of playing a5 that also was possible earlier in the opening, but because here if he tries a3, I can simply take, and I can take this, and now this bishop is going to be some kind of little bit of a problem for white. After takes, and I can take here, and now I can maybe play queen here in center, because this bishop is not protected, and if the black king moves up to protect this pawn, there's also a target here on h2. So that was something to look at, but I played b takes c5, which was an inaccuracy. He took, and now I played rook to e8, trying to put some pressure on this pawn, and I want to play my bishop back and then play g6 and get my bishop over here and attack here, and after that I wanted to play my knight here and put it to a better square, and now also open up for my bishop and get my rook to this open file. That was my plan. And he castled long, and now I played bishop to f8, and he blundered or played an inaccuracy. Maybe I was also a little bit surprised of this move, knight to f1. I think this e4 is a stronger move, and here I would definitely be under more pressure. And here he could also continue with h4, and I could maybe get my rook out, and I think he would have actually a little bit better position here than me, due to his attack on the king side. But he played knight to f1, so you might say, okay, what could I have played instead of bishop f8? Maybe rook to b8 is a better, but I don't know. He could maybe here, and I think if I take here, I think still I'm going to get pressured here in the center. So maybe we can just turn the engine on here, see what it proposes. G6 first, and then e4, and now it wants to play knight here. Okay, and it gives a advantage to white. So it's an interesting position with chances for both sides, I think. It's a little bit hard for me to see the nuances here, but if you are a strong player, stronger than me, please let me know in the comments. Here I played knight f1, I played g6, and here rook to d2, and I continue with my plan here of putting my bishop to a good square, pinning the rook and king. If he was going to move here, of course. And now he defended the e3 pawn, and I continue with my plan here of getting my pieces into a good position. And here my idea is that I'm threatening the take here on d4. So I played knight to f8, played h3 to stop any threats of my bishop coming here and putting taking the knight. I played knight to e6. Now I have a threat of taking here. He moved his king out of the way, so now I can no longer take. And here I played queen a5, putting my queen to a attacking square. And after bishop to c1, I played bishop to a6, because I thought this bishop is his best bishop, and if I can exchange that with mine, he will be left with this dark squared bishop that's a little bit blocked in behind his own pawns. So I thought it would be a good trade for me. He now played knight to g3. I took the bishop, and he took it with the queen. Here, rook to b8, trying to get to the open file. And he played rook to h2. The engine says that it's better to try to get the king out of danger this way. But I think I have a good position anyway. I now played knight to g7. Actually, there's a stronger move, or I don't know if it's stronger, but it's an interesting move. You might pause and see if you can spot it. It's not completely obvious move, but Stockfish really likes it. It's knight takes c5, just giving up the knight for a pawn. Here Stockfish gives that black is 1.5 pawns since better, and it's simply because this king is out in the open, and there's a lot of threats from the rooks, and the bishop and the queen is all actively placed, and black's pieces are not very very good placed. So but I would never play a move like that in a game, so it's a little bit ridiculous to look at it. But there's a lot of possibilities in positions like that. My opponent played rook to g2. I continued with the plan of trying to exchange his best pieces off the board, and my idea was that maybe I could get some kind of pressure on the center, or in maybe if he plays f5, I could get my knight here into e4. So he played f4, I took, and here I was actually very close to playing this move, and I thought, oh, when I realized that was a blunder, but actually it's not a blunder, because if the queen takes, I can simply take this knight, and black is still has a good position here. But I went with the knight to h5, and after he's played back here and played knight f6, and here I played knight to e4 into the center, and I was getting quite low of time here, and it's beginning to be a pattern in my games that I'm using too much time in the opening, so I need to work on that. And here he took, and I was looking at rook takes here, but I couldn't see anything after rook to b2, and if I going to double, he could play something like rook b3, and I think my rook here would just get stuck against this pawn. So I decided to play a little more interestingly and take with the d pawn, and now the queen is forced away, and now I tried to reroute my queen, or there was several options with it. So I played back to queen to d8, and here he played queen a4, attacking this pawn, but I thought it's not really dangerous for me if he takes it. So I played queen to d5, and let's take a look if he's going to take. I can take here, play rook here, and after something like this, I can get my queen into a really dangerous position, because there's a good check here if this rook is going to move. So I think I had an even if he's going to take here, I can play something like rook to b8, and now there's threats here. I think white is in real trouble here. But he didn't take on h7, and I played bishop to f8, trying to work on this pin. So he played queen to c2. I think he could have played rook to g8 here, which would probably have been a better move, but he didn't do that. And I replayed rook to b2, b5. I could have played maybe something like bishop to e7, just putting pressure on this pawn. But after rook to b5, he played queen e1. Again, rook g5 is the best move. Just to have a look here, I can then move my queen back, and the game continues from there. But after king to e1, I played queen to h5, trying to get it closer to the king and putting pressure on this pawn. And he protected it. And now I put more pressure on the pawn. And here he got his king away to safety, he thought. And it doesn't make sense to take it here, because now I'm just pinning my queen. So after this move, I thought, okay, now I have some good ideas to come over to the queen side with my bishop. And after bishop to b2, I played queen to d5. And now I think my piece is getting into a really good positions. And he tried to defend with a3. And here I gave a check. Bishop to a5, check. And I was down to 1 minute here, closing down to time control at 40 moves. He played queen to king to c1. And now rook to b8, putting more pressure on the position. Here I played a little bit strange move, queen b1, which is, plus the blocking his king away, but it's pretty hopeless position anyway. So I played queen rook b3, and now queen a1, and here I gave a check, queen c4, and he now played his king into the set to b1 in front of my rooks, but he also has two rooks and a queen protecting this bishop. I did not find most forcing line, which you might want to pause and see if you can find the quickest win. And that is queen to bishop to c3. I'm getting a little bit tired now. And now he can't really do anything. And it's all over. But I played, rook to d3, trying to get it back here, and now he will get checked here if he doesn't move his rook back to h1. And now I play my queen to b3, and now I want to give a check and then pick up this rook. So he moved over to c1, and here I put the rook to d1 anyways, he blundered here, and played the queen to a2, and I simply took here on c1. And after, he can't take with the bishop because it's pinned, so he has to take with the queen, and now I can take his queen. So let's see what's the best defense here is, probably the rook here, and then I can take here, and then probably best is just to take this pawn, and now I can take this pawn and this pawn, and it's falling apart for him. I think I played a reasonably good game. My time control was not the best, but again, I was the last to finish. But I have now two wins in the league games, and in this since the summer, I have 4 wins and 1 draw and 1 loss. So I'm quite happy with my over the board results so far. Hope you liked this analysis, and please subscribe, and I will here in the weekend play a weekend tournament, so a lot of more chess for me. Bye.